Creating a WordPress child theme provides a secure way to customize your theme's code without risking your original theme. This is particularly beneficial when making direct edits to CSS, HTML, or PHP files. The key advantage of a child theme lies in preserving your customizations. So, even when the parent theme undergoes updates, your modifications stay unaffected. In today's video, we'll explore all the essential aspects of WordPress child themes, including a step-by-step guide on how to create one. But let's first delve deep into what a WordPress child theme is. A child theme is a type of WordPress theme that inherits all functionality, features, and style from the parent theme. So, any modifications made within the child theme do not affect the parent theme. This is because the child theme is stored in a separate directory from the parent theme. It also comes equipped with its own style sheet and function files, which are required for a theme to work. By accessing the relevant CSS and PHP files, you can modify various elements of your theme, even those that might not be present in the parent theme. Here's how the child theme works. When a visitor accesses your website, WordPress loads the child theme first. Then, it fills in any missing styles and functions using components from the parent theme. This results in the best of both worlds, the core functionality of the parent theme and the customized design of the child theme. Child themes come with many advantages. Firstly, creating a new WordPress theme is efficient as you don't have to code everything from scratch, saving you time and resources. Next, you can customize the child theme without breaking the parent theme's functionality. As we discussed, child theme files exist in a separate directory from its parent theme, so you won't lose any customization during theme updates. Another benefit of the child theme is that it's a fail-safe solution. So, in case you ever misconfigure the child theme, you can still track that part and troubleshoot the issue. Meanwhile, the parent theme functionality is there to serve as backup. Its main advantage is you don't have to worry about the essential aspects, like regular security updates and patches, if you use a parent theme from a reputable developer. But using child themes also has its disadvantages. First, the learning curve can be steep, especially for beginners or non-tech-savvy users. So, familiarizing yourself with its working, including its template hierarchy, can be overwhelming. Nevertheless, the learning process proves worthwhile in the long run. So, if you're a beginner, you can create your first child theme using a parent theme with a less complex structure. Another disadvantage is the dependency of the child theme on its parent theme. If the parent theme's developer decides to make significant changes, such as deleting a feature, it can impact your child theme, especially if you frequently use that feature. In the worst-case scenario, if the developer stops working on the child theme may face security risks, and you may have to discontinue using it to avoid exposure to potential threats. After exploring the pros and cons of a child theme, let's move on to the step-by-step method of creating a child theme. There are two ways to do it. One is manually, and another method is using a plugin. Start by creating a new folder in your local system or in the themes directory, located at wp-content/themes. It's good practice to name it by adding child to the parent theme's name. For example, if the parent theme is 2022, your child theme folder should be 2022 child. Next, you need to create a style file for child theme. If you're using Bluehost, go to your Bluehost dashboard. Then, click on Advanced. Locate and click on File Manager. Go to Public HTML, then WP Content to access the themes folder. Open the parent theme folder and click on the styled CSS file to copy the header code. Open Notepad and paste this code. Modify the code by adding child in the theme name and then, below theme URI, add template, theme name in the new line. Once done, save this file as styled CSS inside your child theme folder. As this styled CSS file doesn't contain any styles, we need to import them from the parent file. The best way to do it is using function.php file. To create function.php file, open Notepad and add the code. Save this file as function.thp in the same child theme folder. Now create a zip file of the child theme folder. To install the child theme, go to the WordPress backend. Navigate to the Appearance tab and click on Themes. Next, click on the Upload button. Choose the zip file from your local drive and click Install Now. If you are creating these files in the theme directory, you don't need to create a zip file or install it on the WordPress backend. It will automatically reflect on the WordPress's theme section. To activate the child theme, go back to the Themes page. You'll see the newly created child theme listed. Click on Activate to start editing the child theme. To start, go to the WordPress backend. Locate the Plugins tab on the left navigation panel and click on Add New. In the search bar, type Child Theme Configurator. Click on Install and then Activate. Now, go to the Tools tab from the left navigation panel and click on Child Theme. On the new page, select a parent theme for which you want to create a child theme and click on Analyze. Next, you can edit the name of the new theme directory, select where to save the new style, and choose the parent theme stylesheet handling. Click on Edit Child Theme Attributes. Here, you can edit the child theme name, theme website, author name, author website, theme description, theme tags, and version. An important option is number 8. It replaces the child theme's existing menus, widgets, and other customizer settings with those from the parent theme. Click on the checkbox to allow it. Finally, click on the Create New Child Theme button. To check the newly created child theme, go to the Themes tab on the left navigation bar and click on Appearance. Here, you'll see the child theme you just created. Click on Activate to start editing the child theme. You can delete the Child Theme Configurator plugin once you finish creating the child theme. But don't delete the parent theme, as the child theme depends entirely on it. Here are some things to check for if your child theme isn't working. First, double-check your functions.php file. Typos or errors in the functions.php file can disrupt your child theme. So, check for any syntax errors or misplaced code. Next, ensure your child theme's main stylesheet is named styled CSS. WordPress relies on this naming convention. This is why it's also important to use the correct template name in styled CSS file. The template name in your child theme styled CSS should match the folder name of your parent theme. This allows WordPress to recognize it as a child theme. You can also try clearing your WordPress cache. Sometimes, cache data holds old information. Clearing them may help reflect the changes you made. If the issue persists, reach out to your theme support. They may have specific insights into compatibility issues or conflicts. Theme forums can also be valuable for finding solutions. So, do you really need a child theme? Well, it depends on your need to modify your theme's CSS and PHP files. If you make frequent changes to these files and have sufficient web development skills, then a child theme is highly recommended. But if you rarely find the need to modify these files or have no intention of doing so in the future, then you might not need a child theme. Many WordPress themes already offer a wide range of design possibilities. For simple customization, you can use the WordPress Customizer feature. It has an additional CSS section where you can add custom CSS for making changes, like modifying the theme's background and other site elements without the need for a child theme. You can also use a CSS plugin to edit CSS files if you often need to make changes. Creating a child theme involves strategic choices to ensure a smooth and effective customization process. So, here are some tips and tricks to help you. First, select a parent theme that closely aligns with your theme's goals in appearance and functionality. This minimizes the extent of modifications needed. Next tip, choose your parent theme from a reputable developer so you receive regular updates and security patches, maintaining the reliability of your theme. Lastly, use a staging environment when activating your child theme for the first time instead of making changes directly on your live website. This way, if any errors occur, you can avoid crashing your live website and troubleshoot in a controlled environment. That wraps up today's tutorial. If you find it helpful, show some love with a thumbs up, share the video with your friends, and make sure to subscribe to our channel for more WordPress-related videos. Feel free to share your thoughts and questions in the comment section below. Your feedback is always appreciated.